Hey, what's up, Coach?
What's up, man?
Hey, your take on the Canelo Chavez?
Man, you got the video, dog. I called it. I mean, I didn't think it was going to be that lopsided, but I'm like a morning back quarterback right now, Monday morning quarterback. I knew that jab would make a difference, but I didn't realize it would make such a difference with the step back. I'm sure people are going to, I'm sure Chavez's weight cut affected him in some way, but he looked lost, and he's just shown that he's been a fighter that's been basically taken care of a lot. So, you know, Canelo's, you know, he's done what he has to do. Now the big test is Triple G.
So who are you going for that fight? Who do you like?
Right now in that fight, I'm like 50-50, bro. When camp starts and I start seeing and hopefully we get called for sparring again, I'd be able to decide my fighter. Ulises Sierra said when he got hit with the jab, he felt that jab all the way to his toes.
Wow.
So I know that had an effect on Chavez Jr. You know, he wasn't comfortable. He couldn't set up.
Okay. So as far as everything else, if you had to bet your house, though, later on.
Who?
Chavez or Triple G?
Chavez?
Not Chavez. Or
Triple
Canelo
G?
Or Triple G?
I go 51-49, like I said last time. I go 51 for Canelo and 49 for Chavez. I'm confused with the names now. Triple G. Only because it seems like Triple G has been declining in his output. You know, the fight with Kell Brook and the fight with Jacobs. I don't know if I'm missing a fight before that, in between those, but, and then Canelo's been going up. So they're gonna meet at the right time. It's business, man. It has to be the right move for Canelo being on the A side. So,
message to your fans?
Oh man, I appreciate you guys. That's it, man. I appreciate all the fans and we appreciate everything.
All right, thank you.